aina yes. eka mitä mediaa edustatte ja nimenne. So first tell your name and which media yeah. you represent.
Kimmo Rantanen Ilta-Sanomasta.
Kimmo, mä annan sulle tästä ensimmäisen. Moi, pitkästä aikaa.
Kuin myös. Moro. Tässä kohtaa kysyä, että voitteko oikeinen biisi? Sä sanoit tosiaan, että sulla on joku ennuste.
Joo, mun ennuste oli itse asiassa väärin.
Okay.
Joo, mutta mun ennuste ei ollut mun favoritti, se oli mun ennuste. Ei mulla ollut favoritti, kaikki oli ihan yhtä samalla viivalla. Ja ollaan tehty semmoinen allianssi tosi aikaa sitten. Sebu ei ollut kirjoitustöissä mukana kahdessa muussa biisissä, mutta hän silti otti tehdäkseen tämän koko homma. Ja myöskin se, että ei mulla ollut, mä oon pelkästään nyt onnellinen, että Lukuva ei ole toi show. Nyt taas kaksi kertaa tänään tehneenä, niin mennään aika lujaa ja ylpeänä eteenpäin.
Hello, Adrian from Spain, ESCBlast.com. I have a question regarding the performance. Congratulations, guys. All the performances were amazing.
Thank you.
I tell you now, it's something different from Poland last year. I think it's different, and I think it's fresh, and I think it's quite cool. You guys did a great job with the performance. How are you going to improve for Tel Aviv, the whole overall show, because the stage is different? Do you have something in mind?
Well, basically, now when we know which one we're going to go with, I think we're gonna put the every last effort we got to that one song and just think about it. I think we don't have a lot of time. Okay, well, but we're gonna give it our all. I'm actually quite happy what we did, but we're gonna pimp it out if we can and yeah. do what we can.
I think, not I think, I am very, very happy how the Look Away turned out. Every track was great today. And right now...
It was such a blast. No, honestly, it was
exactly. But it was right now, I'm not saying we're not going to improve, but right now I feel that we don't have to because it was good today. The only thing we need to do really, our tech team needs to get the stage specs and everything, whatever we can use in Tel Aviv, and we're just gonna bang it a little harder.
But I don't think there's a lot, to change, because we thought about this hard, and I think we're satisfied what we got right now. So I mean, and we're not gonna like.
Yeah, no, we're not gonna change it. We're gonna maybe add a little touch here and there.
Maybe change the singer or something.
And are you planning to do any pre-parties or any promotional tour?
Yes, we are. I'm happy to announce. Can I do it? We're gonna do London, Amsterdam, in Spain.
Yay! Great.
I mean, yeah.
At least those. It's a tight schedule for the with the rehearsals and stuff for the spring. But those at least, and we're looking into other possible stuff still. But I'll see you there.
Yes. We'll try to make it.
Cool. Yeah.
I can take this in English because we have international press.
Om du vill, svenska
är bra. Svenska!
Sebastian, jag tänkte faktiskt ställa frågan till dig. Du har ju skrivit den här låten. Det måste ju kännas bra för dig att gå och åka iväg med en låt som du själv har skrivit.
Ärligt, det känns bra. Jag vill inte säga någonting before tonight. Men om man är ärlig när man skriver en låt som Ville sen ordnar på nytt, betyder att det är ju din egen baby, vet du, på ett sätt ändå. Men jag är en professional, I try to be professional, so I am, hopefully. So I didn't, prefer anything before this show. I give my best to everything, into all the songs, and this is just how it went.
And if you didn't, I would have heard it.
So pretty bad.
I think.
Det känns bra.
Yeah.
Det känns faktiskt bra. Det känns att jag har gjort någonting rätt.
Min svenska är inte så bra, men så.
Tillräckligt bra.
Yeah, I think that Sebu gave his all on all the tracks, and I mean I've worked with him before. I know the guy, so I had no doubts on any of that. But at the same time, I think it's actually pretty damn neat that he's there with actually a piece that he wrote. So, and I had a part of that missing his amazing rock sort of ballad, half tempo thing up, make it in a dance track, and now we're in it together, so that feels good.
I have one more question. In the first semifinal, you are lucky to compete against two other dance tracks, Estonia and Czechoslovakia. Have you heard them songs?
Bring it on.
I honestly, I think Sebo is of us, the guy who, it's not that he doesn't care, but I think he wants to concentrate on his own stuff. I've actually taken a look. I've seen the Estonian one, and it's a great track. Great song.
I've heard that one too. It's a great track.
And music as a contest is weird for me. I know this is a contest, so it's not that I don't want to win. I want to, and we're going to do our best. But the whole point is, every country is going to have great tracks, and we're going to see which style, which performance there, then it's going to take the cake. And one of the greatest things about it all, this is my first time in Eurovision. Everyone else, like Krista Siegfried from our camp, so to say, they've all told about this great Eurovision family, and we've felt that right here in Finland right now, and we're going to feel it in Tel Aviv, and that's one of our main things we want to experience. So contest, yes, but party even more, yes.
I have another question, guys. I don't want to go much into politics, but recently something happened in Ukraine with the Ukrainian singer. The national broadcaster resigned to participate because they didn't reach an agreement with the winner of the national selection because of the conflict with Russia and Crimea and stuff. I know that it's something that comes into the topic now, but what do you think, or what would you say to this?
There's terrible things happening all the time, everywhere. And honestly, my opinion is, I saw the headline, right? But I didn't like read what's going on because I've been quite busy. Sorry for that. But to be honest, I think we got politics, we got countries, we got borders and walls. Hopefully not in Mexico and America. So fuck you, Trump. But the thing is, what I think is that music and sports are the only real things that break borders,
yeah,
and tear down walls. So I mean, we just want to do what we do and bring people closer to us. And so I mean,
I think we don't know that, for instance, the Ukrainian representative or who was chosen and now denied the representation. It seems weird for us, but I don't think we have much say in that, because we don't know the whole history, we don't know all of that, and it's obviously a delicate thing. We can't comment without knowing all the sides. So but I think one of the main things is music unifies people, and that's why we're doing it anyway.
There's no borders or walls in music or sports, so let's just have fun and bring the world together.
I'm actually curious about what of the performances, or the three performances, which was the one that cost you the most of time to prepare, and what was the hardest of all of them to prepare and all behind them?
I think they're pretty equal.
For me, Superman was the easiest in the sense that, as silly as it sounds, but I was mostly doing a couple of keys in the breaks and the intro and jumping up and down and sort of doing what I do when I do a DJ set. And not trying to pretend that I'm doing more. I'm just, in that song, I was just having fun. The choreography for both Release Me and Look Away was quite involved, but mostly for him. And I think you got it down really quickly on both, like the moving walkway thing. And then technically, I don't know if you need to know that, but the spinning the box turned out to be a little bit of a hassle in Look Away in the beginning, but we sorted it out, so it's all good.
I think it was a good choice that I don't dance in anything, because I'm probably the Finnish worst dancer you've ever seen.
Yeah, and I'm dancing very well with my feet in one place and nodding my head.
Thank you.
Linus Hoffman from Svenska Yle. Vad är det som gör att just den här låten var den som var favoriten både bland internationella juryn och i hela Finland? Varför som gjorde just den här?
Jag tror att det var stor, det var säkert hur det såg ut just nu när vi gjorde det, the visuals. Och sen tror jag också att det är igen på något sätt 2019 så är det trendigt att vara politisk aktiv. Så att kanske det är någonting som människor vill, som människor tänker på just nu, och det är helt cool att bara säga någonting vad du tycker. Kanske det, jag vet inte.
But at the same time I think that, sorry again, my Swedish is bad.
He's talking English.
Yes. Or Finska, which do you prefer? But there are English-speaking people. I think also, like, it's non-political, but it tries to bring up things that we could all think about.
Yeah.
You could point to different kind of politics, of course, but we're talking about just raising thought of whatever anybody could do better in their life, whether that's whatever.
Well, the thing is not to preach, but the thing is when I've got a boy, he's like 2 years and 5 months now, and a girl who is almost 5 weeks old. And to be honest, when you think about the world, what's going on right now,
is it in my head?
And you think what they're going to do in 20 years, it's fucking scary. It is. If somebody asked me 20 years ago that what's going on in America right now, I would be like, no way. No way, man, no. It's got to be liberal, it's got to be good, everybody has their rights. But here we go.
And now we go political.
Yes.
Thanks for your patience.
Kiitos. Tuosta Lukovai siitä showsta, niin tyylikäs show, ja näin jonkun verran ihmiset mietti sitä, että sä oot siellä boksissa, niin aika paljon niin kuin pois näkyvistä. Niin mikä teidän näkökulma siihen, että haluaisiko ihmiset nähdä enemmän niin kuin sua, vai onko se mietitty tarkkaan, että se menee näin?
No ensinnäkin se on mietitty todella tarkkaan, mutta sitten toiseksi niin mietin sitä itsekin jossain kohtaa, kun työryhmä meidän tekniikkatiimistä ja koreografit ja muut tavallaan toi tämän ajatuksen, että meillä oli se niin kuin, tavallaan se boksi ja muu juttu, mutta sitten että se pyörii ja kuinka kauan pois siitä niin poispäin. Mutta sanotaanko näin, että mä en ole mun ruutuajasta niin mustasukkainen sen suhteen, koska se tarina toimii. Meidän upea tanssija Etel on siellä päällä ja sitten se tipahtaa sinne boksiin ja se kuvaa jotain siinä videossa ja se toimii. Ja sitten tavallaan mulle pääasia siinä ensimmäisessä nostossa niin kuin tanssimusamaisesti, niin mä oon näkyvissä ja mä pääsen siihen haippaamaan ja näkemään yleisön livenä täällä. Niin sitten niin kuin, sanotaanko mun DJ-näkökulmasta tyydytti kaikki mun ne, mitä mä halusin siitä biisistä. Ja sitten sen takia niin mulle on fine olla siellä boksissa. Toki se on, niin kuin sä bongasit, niin se on vähän hassu konsepti toisaalta, mutta sitten myöskin niin mä oon ollut sen aikaa duunaamassa juttuja, että ei se ollut niin kuin semmoinen ego-kysymys, että onko mä näkyvissä vai ei.
Mihin menette juhlimaan nyt? Vai menettekö?
Oho. Oho.
Tai sanotaan, että miten?
Hei, jatkot. Meillä on tässä näin nyt aika kohta, kun päästään teistä eroon. Ei pahalla. Mä luulen, että me mennään käymään tuolla mun pukkarissa. Ja me saatiin siellä semmoista UMK-moottoriöljyä, joka täytyy tsekkaa.
Mä en tiedä yhtään, mistä Ville puhuu, mutta siis mä ainakin menossa juomaan vissyy, syön pari sipsukkaa ja sitten nukkumaan.
Ja sitten Turussa on tänään monestakin paikkaa hyvät menot, että jos siellä ootte, niin let's slap high fives if you're out and about with us later on tonight. Celebration time it is.
Ei, totta kai tänään on bileet, siis tämähän on hieno ilta ja mä yritän pysyä hereillä vielä 1.5 tuntia.
Tuore iskä.
Siellä. Moi Antero Seiskasta. Mä en tiedä miten paljon te olette seurannut aikaisempien vuosien Euroviisuskavoja, mutta siellähän on tuttuun tapaan eri maat ja delegaatiot järjestää isoja bileitä, niin minkä maa...
Yritätkö katsoa nyt, että mihin kannattaa Panu Hörkkä lähettää ottaa paparazzi kovia?
Minkä maan bileet teitä kiinnostaa kaikista?
Mä luulen, että meillä on luonnostaan, niin mennään ainakin semmoisiin, en tiedä maakohtaisesti, jonkunnäköisiin Nordic-bileisiin, mutta sitten mä tunnen muutaman tyypin kohti, jotka on tulossa sinne eri delegaatioista, niin en tiedä mennäänkö mihinkään tarkkoihin bileisiin, mutta johonkin mennään slappaan high fiveit kuitenkin. Mulla on siis sähköpostiosoite 7.fi, että koko aika tulee tietoa, missä ollaan.
Tyly ilme on toimittaja.
I'm curious about on internet, because this is a competition, and what are you feeling when you read all the negative? You get a lot of positive also in social media, but when you are in Eurovision, you are in a social media storm of opinions. How do you react to this? Do you read them, and what do you feel?
I'm an idiot. I do read them. And I don't lose any sleep about that, but especially the unfounded sort of stupid comments I don't understand. Like, if you don't like my music or his or ours, you don't have to, but how do you find the negativeness and the time to go and sit on your computer and post crap? That I don't understand. But that's all a part of the thing too. And I mean, not to pull the age or career card, but I've been doing this for about 20 years now, and I've gotten a lot of good and bad feedback. And the main key is really to realize and understand that if you see negative feedback, that's basically, 2% of the people making the most noise. The 98% of the people don't make noise, and unfortunately that's not the, that's the positive stuff, because especially Finns, we don't say what's good. If it's just quiet if it's good, and if it's bad you go and
Can you guys send a message to the international fan community on ESCplus.com?
Of course. Here we are.
What should we say?
Face to face, looking forward to tomorrow.
Absolutely.
I'm Ville Drew. This is
I'm Sebu.
And
okay, let's use the microphone. We're gonna
do it again.
We're gonna see.
Start here.
All right.
And then we do it again.
Hi, I'm Ville Drew. This is
Sebu.
And
Sebastian.
We are going to see everybody along the way to Tel Aviv, and we're gonna rock the place down there.
Hopefully.